I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cream cheese chocolate chip cupcakes. And I think you'll enjoy this recipe. It has a lot of parts, but you can make it in a simpler fashion, and I'll tell you how. I want to thank Alan Kent again for the apron. I decided to wear it this time. I knew there'd be a lot of flour flying, and I thought, well, might as well just make use of that apron. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it, even though I am wearing it for the first time today, for real. We're going to start by making a filling, because the cream cheese and chocolate chip part of these cupcakes is in the filling. And you don't actually have to put the filling in, you just put it on top and the cupcake swallows it up and then you have it inside. So that's what we're going to do here. I'm starting with a block of cream cheese. This is actually Neufchatel cheese. It's 8 ounces and it's softened. You can see I've tested with my fork already. It's 8 ounces. Put that into a good sized bowl that you can use your mixer with. And then you have 1/3 cup of white granulated sugar. Those two things we're going to mix together. So here we go. It'll take a little bit. Having creamed the cheese and sugar together, we're ready to add 1 egg and beat that in. For the last ingredient of our filling, we have chocolate chips. These are semi-sweet chocolate chips, 6 ounces. And for this, we're not going to mix them because that probably would break them up a little bit. We want them to stay nice like this. Just stir them around with a spatula. And once they're combined properly, set them aside, and then we will set up and work on our cupcakes. Now, if you don't want to make the cupcakes, you could just buy a cake mix and put it together according to the instructions on the back and use that as your mix. And you'll have some nice chocolate cupcakes that you can use the filling with. And I'll show you how to use the filling after we finish this version of cupcakes. But this is from scratch and I think you'll enjoy it. We start with 1 cup of cocoa powder, and I just need a small bowl to put that in. And with this, I'm going to mix 2 cups of boiling water. You probably see the steam coming off of it, maybe a bubble or two coming up, but I'm going to mix these together. Another good place for me to have my apron on, just in case. That's very hot. And I want to stir it around and then just let it sit and cool while I'm doing some of the other things of this recipe. Our cocoa powder and hot water is mixed, and we're just going to let that sit as we come over to a large bowl into which we're going to put 1 cup of butter. And this is at room temperature, so it's softened. Just put those in. It's 2 sticks. And then put in 2 1/2 cups of white granulated sugar. And at the same time, you may go ahead and put in your 4 eggs. Those are whole eggs, yolk and white. And then we have 1 1/2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Put that in. Now this has to be mixed very thoroughly, so we're going to be beating this with a mixer for about 5 minutes. Here's what our mixture looks like after beating for 5 minutes. Now, since I beat this for 5 minutes, it was pretty tiresome, and I would suggest that if you have a stand mixer, which I do, you might want to use it in a situation like this. I usually just grab the hand mixer and it's easy and convenient, but when it's 5 minutes worth of mixing, you might try a stand mixer if you have it, but if you don't, it's fine. Now we're going on to our dry ingredients, I have flour, which I measured out with dry measure cups and just poured it into this liquid measure because it was something big that would hold it. This is 2 3/4 cups of all-purpose flour. So I'm putting all of that in a very large bowl. I need a very large bowl to do the final mixing. Now I do have some leavening and seasoning agents. I have 2 teaspoons of baking soda. I have 1/2 teaspoon baking powder, and I have 1/2 teaspoon of salt. So those are going to be mixed in here. And what I'm going to do is take a spatula, nice and clean, so that this does not stick to it, and just go around and get this mixed together. And then it becomes a procedure of trying to get my batter, which is here, along with my mixture of boiling water and cocoa powder, which has cooled down a little bit, and I don't have to worry about cooking the eggs or anything like that. But I will be taking a little of each one at a time and using my mixer to mix it in. So there's a little bit of the batter part, and then I brought a ladle over to do this part. And it doesn't have to be full. You just want to get some of this in. There's my spill already. And then we use our mixer. I'll continue to do this until it's all combined. Here is our batter, and you do not want to overbeat this. So as soon as you have everything incorporated, then probably that is enough. And that's what I've done here, and I'm ready to start putting my cupcakes together. And I have put paper liners in a muffin tin that holds 12, and that's all I'm going to do in this session, although this will make quite a bit more than that. But I'm going to demonstrate how I would fill one of these, and then I'll fill them all, and then we'll be baking them at 350 degrees for say 12 to 15 minutes, or I'll keep track of the time and tell you how it is with my oven set at 350. Now as far as filling them, you can use a big spoon like this, or you can use an ice cream scoop like this. We'll start with this and see how you like this. So you just go in and get some of your batter, and this is very drippy actually. So just come over and put it in here, and then on top of this, you're going to take 1 teaspoon and get some of your filling. It needs to be a heaping teaspoon that you put on top, and it will sink a little bit, but that's all right. I will continue to do that all the way around, and then we'll bake them. Here's our pan ready for the oven, and I just wanted to show it to you so you would get an idea of what it's supposed to look like before it goes into the oven. And here's what is left over. That looks like about twice as much as what I used. And also this is left over. So my estimation is that it will make 3 dozen cupcakes approximately. And that depends on how full you fill your paper liners. So I'll show you what these look like when they come out of the oven. Here are our first dozen cupcakes from the oven after 15 minutes of baking. And occasionally I used a toothpick test, and I went in kind of at the side at an angle because I knew at the center was that filling and it might be a little gooier. So I'm going to show you how this comes out. It's down to the bottom and it comes out clean. So you know it's done. It's very hot right now. It's on a cooling rack, and we're going to let it stay there for as long as it takes for them to be cool. Now I like to eat things like this a little bit warm, so I'll be putting these on a serving plate and serving them up to you before long. Here are the cooled cupcakes served on a plate, and I'm going to take a couple out of here and put them on my serving plate, which is over here with a nice tall glass of milk, which is great for this particular dessert. Now, I want you to see the inside of one of these. I'll just peel this back so you can see the texture of the outside as well. And this is very dark looking. It's almost black looking. That's because of all that cocoa we put in it. So you would expect that. Now, I'm going to take a steak knife actually, and cut down through the center so you can see what was going on with that stuffing or filling. Isn't that pretty? Looks delicious. So I'm going to take a bite. And we'll see how it is. It tastes delicious. You have to love dark chocolate in order to love this. But I do. And I usually tend toward those recipes. If you don't like dark chocolate, put less cocoa in and you'll still have a wonderful cupcake that is chocolate flavored and it is filled with this gorgeous cream cheese and chocolate chip mixture. Tastes wonderful. I think you'll love it.